guy's from LA, and he offered me a little situation, and I was like, look, let me just come out there and see what's going on. So when I went out there to see him, he introduced me to some people, and one of the people he introduced me to was named Courtney Benson. And he said, whatever you want to do, I'll help you. So I was like, man, I appreciate that. I knew that that dude was like somebody special that could help me. And he took me to meet Clive Davis in the rhinestone or whatever glitter sequence suit that he had on. I went to see Clive. I was like, man, I'm sitting in front of Clive. And he took me to a couple other record labels. And I remember Clive told me, we rate songs here from 1 to 8. With an 8 being a hit, and a 9 being a top 5, and a 10 being a number 1. He said, you got some strong 7, 7.5. Clive Davis just told me I'm this close to having a hit, you know, and I've already had these songs on the radio. So I know people like these songs. I just got to keep working at it. So I kept working. Courtney took me to meet Nelly. Well, actually, he played my music for Nelly. And Nelly liked it. And he said, you know, fly him out here. Let's talk to him. So I was like, Nelly want to fly me out? I ended up talking to Nelly. I'm sitting in Grand Rapids talking to Nelly on the phone. He said he's going to put me on a flight and stuff. And I'm tripping because, like, I was a big fan of him growing up. And so I went out there. And he said, listen, I'm already an artist myself. I got other artists signed to me. So I know you want to be an artist, but you're making great tracks and hooks. And you can produce and write hooks for us. So I was like, whatever, you know, whatever I got to do. I started doing that with him. First songs I did was like with him and Ashanti and Chingy and all these different rappers in St. Louis, Murphy Lee and some other rappers like in Atlanta, like Young Blush, Sean Paul. You don't give a man, we don't give a. Hey, those dudes, I got to work with them. A lot of people. And it was amazing. Like, I would be in LA with him, I'd be in Atlanta, like, I'd be in Vegas, and it'd just be like Jermaine Dupri. It'd be like, you know, like all kind of stars I would meet messing with him. He's LL Cool J, all kind of people. There's a guy named Master Letic who's got a publishing company in LA. Let's go meet with him. So we met with him, and he was working on the Rob Thomas album, and that's why I was able to get my first hit song. I wrote a song with Matt that he ended up going to finish with Rob, and that became a song called Someday for Rob Thomas. There was probably like a year, I don't remember, at least like a year between when we wrote it and it came out. So in the meantime, I was back to Atlanta and I was coming up to Nashville all the time.